Once upon a time, there were people who lived around the River Seine in Gaul. At that time, honey, Jesus wasn't even born yet. The Romans were a very mean bunch who laughed and spat at the river people. Oh, they called them Parisi, which means hicks, bumpkins, or redneck sugar. A very, very old Parisi woman was dragging two heavy pots, one made of metal and the other made of clay. She was really, really tired dragging those damn pots. And she was really tired of her life. She felt nothing could help her. She was very sad, very pathetic. Zoot! Kill me now! She screamed. Suddenly, Death appeared in front of her. But she didn't mean to call him. So she freaked out and blurted out, "Oh, can you help me carry my pots?"
What is wrong with you?
Who is that in front of the building?
Who?
There is a strange psychic woman. She's crazy.
Crazier than you? I don't know if that's possible. Hey, how was your trip to the Republic of Vanuatu with your boyfriend?
We didn't go.
Why? You guys had so enthusiastically studied the culture together and became fluent in Islam.
I don't want to talk about that. He dumped me.
What?
Uh-huh. Blow me. You. Longer America.
It's not like I wasn't gonna return it. Wait a minute. You said you got back from the airport yesterday. I haven't seen you in like a month. So where have you been since then?
Oui. À Paris.
You were in Paris.
Oui. Alone.
What's the big deal about Paris? I mean, I don't get the appeal. You don't even speak French, do you?
No.
You've never even been to Europe before.
I wanted to forget.
What do you want to drink?
Spring water?
Oui, merci.
So, you wanted to forget about
them? I wanted to get distracted.
Distracted? You mean destructed? You are the deliberate cause of all deadly disaster in this world.
I am not.
You destroy everything.
When I was reading a newspaper, I saw an ad about Paris, and I thought that would be perfect for my distraction.
When did you even leave? I mean, was that around 2 weeks ago? That big earthquake that was in Japan?
Yes, that was right after that.
I saw that on TV. It was horrible. I was like, wow, did someone bomb Japan? And then it was an earthquake, so...
I wished I were then in Japan and get killed by the earthquake. Because I felt I was happy and peaceful if I was sleepy. I wanted to sleep forever.
You, been eating any apples that have been sold to you by old women lately?
Did you just say old?
No.
Pierre reminded me so much of him. So I wanted to keep myself so busy, so I couldn't even have to think about him.
I thought you guys were doing fine, though. I mean, what's the big deal?
Yes, I thought we were doing fine, too.
So how was Paris?
Oui, c'est magnifique et très intéressant. But it was raining all the time.
What time did you arrive?
Well, I arrived there around 8, and I was so tired.
8 in the morning.
Yeah, evening. In the morning. And then I had to find a hotel.
Really? You didn't even bother to make a reservation for your hotel?
Nope. You know, I like to travel without any plan, but walking around there in rain, oh, I was completely lost in Paris.
As usual, you would choose the hardest way, but like it,
you know,
you're living a difficult life.
Well, you know, street names are so difficult to pronounce. They have like so weird French names.
You're in France?
Yeah.
Did you even bother though to ask someone for help?
I did. You know, the people are really nice there.
Really? I always heard that they weren't kind to foreigners in Paris.
Well, I guess it depends on foreigners. They're really nice to me. So I find a hotel.
4-star hotel? Yeah.
You know, there was an old man at the reception hotel.
Old man? Old what? Man?
Yeah.
Older than you?
Yeah.
How old?
He was older than me.
Was this the missing link? He must have been like the only surviving caveman on the planet. Were you attracted to him or something? Why? What happened with this old man? Was he nice to you?
He was very, very kind.
Well?
But he didn't speak any English though.
No English at all?
No, never.
So how did you guys communicate with him? You didn't get into any trouble with him, did you?
What kind of trouble?
Oh, I don't know, maybe in a small office, he cornered you and undressed you and forced you to do something very, very kinky.
He didn't.
Maybe. Maybe he looked like an old, miserable, soaking wet beggar again.
Did you say old?
No.
He treated me very well.
Did you at least pay for your room?
I paid!